Hello and welcome to Diagramming Sentences Lesson 1. I'm going to try to attempt to show you how you can take a simple mode of communication called a sentence and draw it on paper, or in this case, on a computer. It's a way that was developed years ago to try to help students understand the relationship between words in a visual way. And I think it's going to help you quite a bit. But you have to bear with me because it's like a puzzle. I want you to think of this whole thing like a game of words. And I think maybe if you do that, you can think about how words interplay and interrelate with each other. This will be a lot easier for you. So just think about this as a puzzle or a game. It'll make it a little easier. I want you to think about a sentence as a line on a piece of paper. There's your metaphor or your analogy. A sentence is a line. And in this case, I'm going to create a sentence for you and show you how to take it and put it on a line. The sentence is going to be, the dogs howl. That's simple, okay? And that sentence has two words in it, which makes it really easy for the first one that we're going to do. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to draw a line like I've drawn here. And then we're going to separate the line, this baseline that we've drawn, with a divider. The baseline now has two separate sides. On the left-hand side, we have the subject. In this case, it's dogs. Now, how do I know that? Because I know that dogs are the ones doing the action in this story, or in this sentence. And every sentence tells its own story. The next thing I want to do is I want to type in the word howl. And I'm going to do that now. And strangely enough, that's how this whole thing is done. Now, this is a rather simplistic way of showing you how to diagram a sentence, because what I've done is I've taken the a word over here, this word that's the subject, and I've created the subject part of the line, and then over on the verb side, I've created the predicate. Now, the predicate and the verb are the same thing. The subject and the noun are the same thing. One's part of speech, another's a part of sentence. I don't want you to get that confused yet. I just want you to know that over on the left-hand side of any of these, we get subject and predicate. All right, next, let's go to a new slide, and I'll show you how to get to the next part. I'm going to create a new sentence here, and that is dogs and cats, I'm going to spell that correctly, fight and scratch. Okay, and I want to make that a little bigger. And now I can click on that. Time to draw a baseline. And then we're going to do it just like that. But we have a problem here, and I'll show you what it is in just a second. We have our baseline with a divider. And we have a sentence, but the problem is we have two subjects, dogs and cats, and we have two verbs, fight and scratch. So we have to do this one a little differently. So what I'm going to have to do is continue to draw this diagram in a very specific way, and I'm just going to make it compound, which makes it almost easier. Basically, I'm just going to divide the line, let it branch off, and that's what we're going to call it, branching. And that way we can still put the subjects and the predicates where they belong. So I'm going to go here. Now we have this compound subject, it's dogs. So there's that word, and cats. And let's put those where they belong. So that's one word down, dogs. Here's another word down. We have to use every word in the sentence when we're diagramming it. And now we have to go to the predicate of the verbs. What are the dogs and cats doing? They're fighting and scratching. So fight and scratch. And again, we will take those and we will put them in their appropriate spots. And then we just have a couple of words we have to take care of. And. And so there's a special way to do that. And that's called a coordinating conjunction, by the way. And those go over here, and they're linked together. And we then just put the line in between them, linking them, and we can put the coordinating conjunction in. So we'll type and do that a couple times. And then we'll rotate it a little bit, because it's going to be rotated. And that's done this way. And we'll just take it and put it right over here. And this one will rotate, because it's on the other side of the sentence, rotate it the other way, right there. And now we've successfully used every word in the sentence. Dogs and cats fight and scratch.